Hello, my name is Jacob, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to make edits on OpenStreetMap. For those not familiar, OpenStreetMap is an open source mapping program, much like Google Maps, but all the data is contributed by people, and that means that you can make edits too. If you've ever noticed a problem with a road, a building size, or some really funny directions, OpenStreetMap is a place you can come to make those changes. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to edit a road, how to delete and add some new roads, how to remove a building, and how to edit an existing building. We're going to walk through each of these as we go in the description, as well as the new YouTube thing. There will be timestamps if you were looking for one particular thing. The first thing I'm going to be showing you is how to edit a existing road. So the road we're going to edit here is a one-way road that is currently flagged as two ways. And this can cause issues with navigation where it tells you to go the wrong way down a one-way road. So you're going to go to openstreetmap.org. You're going to sign up with an account. And once you have signed up, you will have access to this edit button. But before we click on edit, we're going to find where we want to make an edit. So the one-way road I'm looking at is right here next to Walmart. It is this road that connects Cook Avenue to the Walmart parking lot here. This little connector road right here. This is a one-way road. You can only go from Cook Avenue to the parking lot. So now that I found what I want to edit, I'm going to click on edit here at the top. This will switch us to edit mode. We get to see the buildings. You can see the outlines and all the structures of everything. You'll notice here that there's a building where there is a parking lot. This is a mistake, and we are going to edit that later on in this video. But for now, I want to change this road here to be a one-way road. So using the default cursor tool, which is what you start with, I'm going to click on this road, and I want to look through this left feature menu. Here you can make lots of different changes. We'll be exploring those more later in the video. The one I want to do right now is one way. Right now it says assume to be no. This is the default, but this is not true. This is a one-way road. So I'm going to click on it once, and this will switch it to yes. And we can see a direction here showing from Cook Avenue to the parking lot. This is the correct direction, but if the road you're editing has a different one-way direction, you can click change direction, and that will flip it the other way. But I want it to be this direction. So this is now flagged as a one-way road from Cook Avenue to the Walmart parking lot. This is still a service road. There's no need to change any other settings here. So I've made this change. It's a good idea to not do a lot of changes in a single edit that are not related to each other. So we're gonna be editing this parking lot here, but it's not directly related to this road change. So I'm just gonna hit save. You need to give a comment of what you changed. In this case, I'm just gonna say changed road connecting Cook Avenue and Walmart parking lot to a one-way road. That is my edit. This is so if someone else looks at it, they know what happened. It gives them a little more context here. You can add a field if you want. I'm not going to do that. And if you've done a change that you're not quite sure you did it right and you want someone to look at, you can click this checkbox, I would like someone to review my edits, and that means before this data is published to everyone, someone else will go through and say, yep, you did it right. This is a very simple change. I'm changing the direction of the road. I don't really need that. I'm very familiar with OpenStreetMap. So I'm just gonna click upload. It's uploading my changes. And it's done. And now anyone who loads OpenStreetMap uses this for navigation will know this is a one-way road. So that shows you how to edit a basic road. I'm going to show you how to add some new roads now. So we're going to come back to this location later, but for now I'm going to move across town to this area here. This is a relatively new development in Northampton where we've added a building here on the left that contains a few different stores and a Dunkin' Donuts on the right. These building outlines are a little bit off. It's because the satellite imagery is a little slow to update. Perhaps we'll update this in a future time, but for now I'm going to leave it as it is. We're going to be focusing on the roads here. So you'll notice that these roads are not lining up. For one, it says that there's a tunnel going under Dunkin' Donuts. This road here kind of cuts through the parking lot, drives into the middle of the building, and this doesn't really line up with where the parking lot is now. So we're going to make some changes here. So in this scenario, I think it's the best to just delete these roads and build some new ones. So I'm going to select this road, and I'm going to hit the delete key to get rid of it. And I'm going to do that for all of these roads here. So we've now removed all the roads. It's empty, but there are roads here. So we're going to make some changes here. The first one is we're going to add a line that will go from our main road here over to Industrial Drive, kind of connecting these roads here. So I'm going to add a new line. It's going to start here. We're going to go in, and then we're going to go down and connect there. And then I'm going to hit escape, and that's my road. This we're going to flag as a service road here on the left, and we're not going to really change any other settings here. This is a pretty basic service road. If this was a bridge, a tunnel, that kind of thing, you'd want to label that. If this was a one-way road, you'd want to label that, just like what we did with our other road. But for now, I'm going to leave it like this. We also have this little area here that they can drive down. So I'm going to add another road going down to here, like that. I'm going to hit escape to end my edit. This is also a service road. And again, nothing really unique about this place. The last one we're going to add is this drive-through right here. So I'm going to make a new line that's going to start on the corner here. And we're going to click our points. You don't need a ton of points, but you just want to encapsulate how the road functions. We're going to go around and then reconnect right there. I'm going to hit escape, and here's our new road. So this road is a drive-through. It's not a traditional road. So one thing I'm going to do, because I already have it here in my menu, but you might not, you can use the search here on the left to search for a drive-through. There's also a driveway if, say, you were wanting to add your driveway at home to OpenStreetMap. We're just going to say this is a drive-through. I'm going to click on that. That will change it to a drive-through type. This is a one-way drive-through. You can only go one direction around it. And this corner is a little rough, so I'm going to smooth it up. So if we wanted to add a new point, we can click in the middle of an existing line and drag to make a new point there. So now we've added our drive-through. We've said this is a one-way drive-through, like most drive-throughs are. We've added our roads, our service roads here and here, connecting these things together. You could carry on in this area to add a parking lot or other kind of indications here, but I'm just going to focus on the roads for now. So this is the end of these features. So I'm just going to do one final check over, make sure it's everything how I want it to be. And then I'm going to save my changes here, and I'm going to say updated roads near Dunkin' Donuts in Northampton. So I've just updated these roads. That's what I've done. Last year when they added these buildings, I added these new markers, but it looks like the satellite data has changed a little bit, so maybe we'll have to come back here another time. And I'm going to upload my changes. And now these changes will be published to OpenStreetMap. So now we've added some roads, we've edited some roads, so let's focus on some buildings now. So we're going to go back to the Walmart parking lot, and we're going to take a look at this area right here. So this is currently flagged as a building. It is not a building. I do not know why it's flagged as a building. So we're going to make some changes here. The very simple change we can make is we can select the building. You'll see it's pulsing red. I'm going to hit delete on my keyboard and just get rid of it. But you might notice all the parking lots around here are flagged as parking lot zones. So I want to carry on with this to keep it consistent in this area. So I'm going to add a new area now by clicking on the area tool. And what this does is it lets you click points and you draw a shape. Just like that, when you're done, you can hit escape, and you've drawn a new area. It's very hard by hand to make 90 degree corners. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select a corner by clicking on the vertex for the corner. I'm going to right click and choose square. And this will turn this corner into a perfect square. And you can do that for all of them. And now you have a nice little square parking lot. So I'm going to select this area. It says this area has no descriptive tags. Mapbox really wants you to have descriptive tags. You shouldn't just put areas on a map and not say what they are. So I'm going to click on area type. Then I'm going to search for parking lot. Select that as my area type. This has now been flagged as a parking lot. And we've removed a building. We've drawn a new area. And we've labeled it as a feature type, which is a parking lot. So I'm going to save these edits. I'm going to say removed old building, added parking lot outside of Walmart in Northampton. Just like that. Those are the edits I made. So I'm going to upload those changes. And that will be our basics. And now this is flagged as a parking lot here. The final thing I want to show you is how to edit an existing building. So I'm going to find a building that recently got an addition added to it, which is over here. So this building right here, you'll notice is this shape like this. And if we actually change the background to, yeah, so using Bing aerial imagery, this is an old image. You can see this building used to be the square like this. There's a little cutout curve. I would guess that's for a porch or something like that. But this building doesn't look like this anymore. With our most recent data, 2019, the building looks more like this. So we're going to make some edits to it. So I'm going to select it. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to rearrange these existing points to some new boundaries here, following along the building. Now, these might not necessarily be the perfect boundaries because you have to account for satellite data being a little shifted. You don't want to draw where the shadow is. So this building casts shadows. That's not part of the building, right? Those are shadows on the building. With this outline here, luckily the way it's facing, we have a pretty clear image of what the outside is. So I'm going to select these corners and I'm going to square them off because our building is a square. Here, this might need to be adjusted a little bit. Square that in. And now here's where our first new edit needs to be, is we have a new addition here. So just like our roads, you can double click on a point and that will give you a new point you can move, and we can drag this up to its position. We can do this multiple times to add our new boundaries to our building here. So I'm just double clicking between two points to add a new point, dragging it and placing it into position. And once we do that for all the corners, we can go back through and square them. You can also hit Q if you want to square things quicker. So that's what I'm going to do. Select a point, hit Q, 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 and so on. Some corners you might have to adjust, then hit Q, just so that they don't get lined up with incorrect values. So like this one, there, there, it's just there. So then we got to bring this down. Now this point should be square with all of those. So I'm going to get it roughly in the right place and hit Q to finish off the square. So we've now updated this building here to have its new boundaries that correctly follow the right. And you can be stuck making these tweaks forever. It's usually best to get it as close as you can and from a distance, right? That covers the building much better than it did before. So I'm going to save this. I'm going to say accounted for addition made to building. I don't need anyone to upload these changes. I'm going to upload them. And we have saved those points. So now I've shown you how to edit a existing road. I've showed you how to make some new roads. I've showed you how to delete a building, make a new area that is a parking lot, but you could do the same thing for a building or any other type. And I've showed you how to edit an existing building. Thank you for watching. Again, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments, and I will see you guys in the next video.